In the rugged northwest, from Cascadian Crest, the waters will tumble and plummet. They run and they race from the peak down the face to the feet of Olympian summits, and there they recline neath the fir and the pine in the beds of the numerous rivers, wherein also resides a fish famed far and wide, whose mere name gives the fisherman shivers. The steelhead, in motion downstream to the ocean, is in search of a fine education. He'll rate swimmer cum laude, though merely a trout at the time of his matriculation. Both early and late, this scholar can't wait to attend to his maritime studies, but often at night he'll go out for a bite and a drink with his old halibuddies. The angler crack'll have no lack of tackle, be it bait, be it spoon, be it spinner. He'll hope and he'll pray at the end of the day that a steelhead will join him for dinner. But I'll bet you a buck that this fisherman's luck for a day in cold water and waders will bring a case of the flu, 2 feet icy blue, and a supper of roast beef and taters. Some way fish with a fly as they fly in the face of the fish with a face that is fairest. A fly with a lure like the chic haute couture of those fetching fly fashions of Paris. The fly it is cast, but this fish cries, "Avast, I'd as soon be caught dead as be seen to dine on a fly when I'd just as soon try some fine Thai or Italian cuisine." But this angler's undaunted, though taunted and haunted. He wanted to fill up his creel with that furious creature whose curious feature is a head made entirely of steel. The splendidious, insidious, the Salmo Iridius, who's caressed the salt sea with his tail. A fish so suspicious, so fierce, so delicious, it's the fisherman's holiest grail.